Hello everyone, welcome again. We have another offer in the shop, and there's another bundle. This time is American medium tank on tier 4, the time tested T6E1. Most of the players may be surprised what kind of tank is that, because they never seen it before. And even myself, I never seen it in the shop, just probably once, I think once or twice, in a small side pop-up option, the offer to buy, and that was about £10, I think. So it's very rare tank. No, it's not very popular, and in this video I'll try to explain why it's not very popular. Let's get to the offer first. In the bundle we have the tank itself, T6E1, garage slot, 9 equipment slots unlocked, time tested rare camouflage, 14 days of premium account, 10 certificates for x5 experience, 25 rare gold boosters, and the Charm of Fortune epic avatar. Altogether cost us $4.99, about $5 or 5 euros or 5 pounds. About the tank, if you look at the silhouette here, the shape is similar to, you know, it looks familiar, because it looks pretty much like Sherman. And it's true, this is basically, this is very old, very early Sherman prototype. As you can see, the hull is exactly the Sherman shape. We had small turret, the first small turret with a huge cupola on top, and the howitzer gun. About the parameters, is also nothing special. Is a tier 4, and on tier 4 we have gun with 90 mm of penetration, and alpha damage on is 120 points. On IPCR is 125 of penetration with 105 damage, and high explosive 38 with 140 of damage. Gun depression 10 degrees, which is quite obvious for American tanks, and elevation 20 degrees. Dispersion is 0.422, quite high, but like I said, it's a howitzer gun, so that's quite obvious as well, that high dispersion. And aiming time 4.3, the same situation. DPM of this gun is 671, which is not fantastic because of the reload time. Look, we have 10.7 reload time on this gun. So even for 120 alpha damage, 10.7 on tier 4, don't forget it's a tier 4, it's nothing special, because you're gonna reload, like for most of a battle, you're gonna reload your gun. And then consider the dink or a missed shot, it's gonna be even worse. So it's nothing spectacular. About the speed, the engine here is 400 horsepower. And power to weight ratio is 15.7 horsepower per ton. Nothing spectacular. So it's not very fast tank. Average speed here is 31 km per hour, but usually is about 20-25 km per hour. Also nothing special, seriously, is a very slow starter. So there's not much speed, not much damage. And if we want to talk about the armor, here we have armor profile of T6E1. As you can see, the frontal armor is 83 millimeters, which is quite low, because the average penetration, like I said, is on this gun, for example, on the howitzer, is about 90, and usually that the penetration is about 90 to 100 on the tier 4 guns, so it won't give you much of protection. The lower is even worse. This is one big weak spot here on the bottom with 52 millimeters of armor, so which is quite easily penetrable. Another two weak spots here, 54 millimeters here and 55 millimeters here. So those two, they're big, quite big weak spots in the front. So even if you hold down this tank, you're gonna be easily penetrated here. Another weak spot here on the top of a turret, 53 millimeters, quite big. And the top of that is shaped here, is sloped here, 116. But this one here is only 53 millimeters, and it's almost flat. The turret itself, it has 90 millimeters. So if you wriggle a little bit, it might bounce something, but I will not count on that. 91 millimeters on the cheeks. On the side, again, not very good situation, because we have 38 millimeters around this, all this side, 41 here. So even for tier 3 is quite easy to penetrate. 59 millimeters here, 52 59, and 70 on top, but just because of a slope here, so this is not very good option, not very good situation. 38 millimeters on the back, as always, you know, the back armor is the weakest one. We have 38 39 51 here, And this is a sloped engine cover with 106. So like I said, it's not very good, even if you try to use the hull down, because we have 10 degrees of gun depression. So even if you try to do to position your tank like this, so let's imagine that we have ground level here, and again we have 107, so it's slightly better here, but here is 58, because you're losing the angle here. 59, again two weak spots, and those weak spots gonna stick out, even unless you try to hide all the hull and try to show only the gun, only the turret. So we have 100 101, so tier 4 and 5 probably gonna penetrate the turret as well, and the weak spot is visible of course as well. 53 55 millimeters, because we're losing the slope again. So as you can see, the armor is not very effective. If you look at here, there's armor performance against the other tiers. So if you fight against tier 3, you see most of the frontal armor is penetratable. Again, big weak spot against tier 3. Big spot here, and a big weak spot here. The turret is slightly better armored, and the frontal armor as well. If you look against tier 4, it's pretty much the same situation, and tier 5 even worse, because tier 5 penetrate this tank easily without any problems. So as you can see, there's nothing special. So like I said, this is quite interesting offer for all the tank collectors who wants to collect all the tanks in a game, because like I said, it's quite a rare tank. And for £5, if you want to buy this tank to play, that's going to be tricky, because there's not much players on the lower tiers these days. Tier 4 is quite difficult to get into the battle, and if you want to play comfortably, if you're looking for something to feel fun in the game, I don't think they're going to be good option, because like I said, 10 seconds to reload on tier 4, that most of the time we're going to reload the gun, so even with at such a low speed, you won't get much fun from the game. Anyway, so once again, the tank itself is just a regular tank, nothing special here, sometimes even worse than regulars. So from this side, this is not to buy option. Of course, if you are a collector and you want to get all the tanks in the game, this may be option for you, because the tank itself looks pretty nice. It has a nice camo. Of course, it's worn because it's time tested, so it's like time worn camo. It looks pretty nice, and probably that's it. £5 is not a big price, especially if you compare with the first price that was like £10. So if you're a collector, this is offer for you. If not, I would just avoid that. Right, thanks everyone. I hope I just brought some good information for you guys about this tank, and I may help you to make a decision. If you want to see any more videos, you can browse the channel and find something for yourself. Of course, if you are interested in similar materials, you can subscribe the channel and stay tuned, because the new materials will come very, very soon. Right, thanks everyone for coming, and see you next time. Take care.